Instead of whining about what is bad, we should praise for what is good. Instead of moaning of our situation, we should be in prayer for the need of others and for the glory of God. Instead of reading novels which satisfy our minds for a moment, we should read and study God's word, which will enrich our souls for eternity. Rather than telling others about the latest sports statistics, we should tell others about the great deeds of the Lord and the love of God found in Christ Jesus. These are the type of things we should pursue in order to redeem the time. And the reason why is because, as Paul says, the days are evil. The world is a fallen place, even when things are going really well for us individually. There is still death, there's still sadness, and there is pain for others. When one person is becoming rich, others are in the process of losing all that they have. 1,000 planes may take off safely, but from time to time, one will not reach its intended landing site. I was watching a video as I was scrolling through Mail Online today looking for news articles, and there's a airplane with a very rich person. I don't remember who it was. I think there were 8 people on the plane. One of them was a child that had just been baptized. I think it was in Greece. I'm sorry if I got the details wrong. And they showed the plane going straight down into a building. Okay? Happened today. We don't know when our end is going to be. The tides rise and fall with regularity, but when it is unexpected, a tsunami may come and destroy the land. 250,000 people died a few years ago in Indonesia, wiped off of the face of the earth that quickly. They're out there and they're fishing and enjoying. The tides are coming and going just as they always do.
It was on Christmas, December.
Yeah, it was about Christmas time. All of a sudden, 250,000 people are just wiped off the face of the planet. Man does not know the day of his death, and we can never say when we will meet a friend or a family member for the last time. Life application: the days are evil because they are unknown concerning the next moment. Joy may be heard, but sadness may also be waiting there as well. It is our obligation to make the very most of each day for the positive work of the Lord and for the sake of eternity which lies ahead. Our attitude should be, use me up now, Lord. My time is yours. I'll tell you what happens every Sunday. People, I'm always telling them, I got to leave early. I can't stay on Sunday. I need to go home. And this reminds me, I'll tell you what my Sunday is like. I get up at the same time, 3:30, and then I start work right about 4 o'clock after reading the Bible. So it's about 4 o'clock, and I immediately start into work. And I do all of the research that I do 7 days a week for the update, because the news service, if I don't get it in the morning, there's so much more by the end of the day that when I get at the end of the day, I've got twice as much work. So I get all of the news for the Sunday update in the morning, and that takes usually an hour and a half. I also should move that back a little bit. The first thing I do after reading the Bible is I first post the morning commentary, okay? And I send it out to the people that I send it out to, that they also post it in certain places. And then from there, I will type the next commentary, which is 12 days from now. So I have 12 days to think it through, and I have 12 days to check it for error and stuff. Okay, so that's done. And then after that, I will practice the sermon. Okay, it usually takes about an hour or so. And, any corrections and anything that needs to be done with that, 6-7 days a week. But on Sunday, I've got the sermon stuff. And then after that, I will normally get the stuff for the report. Okay, all of the news articles. Okay, sometimes, let's see, after I do that, I've got lots of emails that I have to check too in case there's something important. So I'm doing that. Okay, we'll just say it's a really busy time before I leave to come to church on Sunday. And, you know, Mabel was saying she watched the video that Sergio did. You know, I stop at church, at the store, and I buy the stuff for the church. I come into the church and I set everything up and I clean things and do whatever. And so that's busy. Usually up, I get, maybe you know who come early, maybe an hour where we can sit and talk. Sometimes it doesn't happen, but usually we get a little time. And then, of course, you've got all of the church, and that is full the whole time. We're always got something going on, and then church ends, and as soon as I can get out the door, and I don't mean to ever disregard anybody, that's not my intention, but there's a lot of work to do. I leave here, I get home, and as soon as I get home, I start working, getting the things from the church off that disk into the computer, and while that's downloading, which takes about 2 minutes, I'm taking the sheets out of the sermon so that I'm ready for that. Okay, I've got all of these things ready, and then I have to start editing three things. First you, and then I have to edit the report, and then I have to edit the sermon. And then while the, we'll say the report is rendering, then I have to start editing the sermon. So that's going on at the same time. And then I render that, and I've got to upload them to YouTube and or Rumble. Okay, so that's all going on. The point I'm getting about redeeming the time comes in a minute. And that's all just my regular stuff. But I've got all that, and it's very, to me, it's very tedious work because I'm not good with computers. And if I mess up anything, I have no idea how to fix it. I have to do exactly what I was taught by Sergio. And Sergio knows that if I touch anything wrong, which happens, your finger hits a button and everything kind of, he has to come into the computer and he has to fix it. And I hate doing that to him because he's got his own life. But he waits patiently every Sunday. And I always give him an update. I'm done with this and I'm doing this. So I want him to know that I haven't messed things up. But it's real tedious for me because it's stuff I don't understand. And I've got somebody that's dependent on me like a little kid, you know, in case I mess it up. And that's tedious on me. But what happens after all of that is done is not the end of the day. Because now I have to take everything that was from that Sunday and I have to move it to files that are complete. And I have to move everything for next Sunday into new files that were where those were. And if I don't do that, I will have no time during the week where it's logically correct to do that. All of that has to be transferred. All the photos, all the graphics, all of the sermon, everything has to be done. Okay? And so that's tedious work too, because it's using the computer and things that I don't quite get. And it's a lot of work for me to do this every single Sunday. And then after that, I need to practice the sermon that is 8 weeks out. And the reason why is because if I don't do that on Sunday afternoon and get all the graphics ready for it, then it will never get done. It's the only time I can logically do this. If I don't do it, the week work is going to be very, very complicated. So I have to do that, and I've got to do all of the graphics, and this takes me usually right up until 6 o'clock. So I have not taken much time off between 4 a.m. and 6. Sometimes it goes longer, depending on what happens, but after that, if I have time, I'll sit down and I'll turn on the TV and I'll turn on a short video. And before I even get it started, Hideko will say, dinner's ready, because she sees I'm done. And I didn't get any time today. And then I get up and I sit and have dinner with her and I'm usually done and I go to bed. But Sundays are difficult, okay? But what? Oh, I got to take care. When Hideko is not home, which is every other Sunday, I have to take care of the dogs, and I've got to fit that in there as well. And that adds in about 15 minutes. I got to take them out. I've got to feed them. I've got to take them out again. So everything is, there's a lot to be done. But the point that I wanted to get to about that, all of that to get to the part about the sermon 8 weeks from now, I don't actually need to do that. Okay, I may be able to find some time during the week that is logical. I've never been able to find one in my mind that I think I can do this day and it will work. Never. So I do it there. But I think every single week before I start doing this, every week, the first thing I think is, if the Lord comes, I will have wasted all of this time today doing something that isn't necessary for 8 weeks from now. But if he doesn't come in 8 weeks from now, if I haven't done that, that sermon that I give to you will not be properly presented. And so I have to think, right here, use me up now, Lord. My time is yours. If I don't do that, it will not be proper for you on Sunday morning 8 weeks from now. And I'm not trying to blow my horn and say how great I am. That's not it at all. The point is that things have to be done. And they have to be done logically. And they have to be done at a point where I'm already completely used up. Completely used up. So that is...
So I'm actually glad you went through all that, because I'm going to combine two topics we've talked about, that and the fact that none of us are getting any younger.
Oh, yeah.
So it's like, you know, I've looked at some of the Church on the Beach stuff. I'm like, who's the young guy?
I know. I used to be young and handsome.
Right. But it's like, you know, there's only so many times a day. You really need to pare that down.
Well, it's the only time I can do it. I mean, I don't know, you know, whatever. But there are some people that help with other things, you know, the little tasty bites that I was doing those because somebody said, would you do these? And so that person would send me all of the things that she wants posted. And now somebody has volunteered to just do them. Yeah. She asked not to have her name mentioned, so I won't. But she said, I want to do these. And she's in a foreign country and she does them faithfully. And then somebody else does the graphics for him. You know who he is. Okay. And so that took out a whole hour during the week, or 2 hours probably, because now the person that wants these,
teamwork.
Yeah. And so, and they just volunteered to do it. I'm so grateful for it, because there are things that I started to say, okay, this is what they want, and I want to do them. And so I cut out my free time from Friday afternoons, which normally I, if somebody visits, that's when I spend time with them, is on Friday. That's my slowest day of the week. And so I try to save that in case visitors come and they want to do something. Friday is it. And, but I was using that time on Friday to do those things. And so now, thank the Lord that he sent somebody to do it. But the things that I do, I can't pare back, and I can't delegate them to somebody else. There are things that I have to do for the church. I you know, if I could delegate it or give it to somebody, if they want to do it, I would, but I can't. So anyway, there you go. Use me up now, Lord. That was the whole point of that long and boring talk. I'm sorry. Use me up now, Lord. My time is yours. And if everybody has that attitude about what they are doing, I don't care what your job is. If you work for the post office, or if you, you know, work at a veterinary clinic or whatever, use me up now. My time is yours. You may be, you know, responsible to a person that doesn't know Jesus, but you do your job faithfully and you do it according to the best you can. But when you have your free time, what are you going to do with your free time? Are you going to spend it, you know, doing this or that or one thing or another? Then the Lord doesn't begrudge us having fun and happiness. That's for sure, because the Bible people have fun and happiness. They have times where they get together and they do things. But there is a time for play and there is a time for work. There's a time for, you know, to be born and a time to die. And as Solomon said, there's a time for everything. What is the most important part of your time? That is what you have to ask yourself, and then use that to the glory of God. Okay.